Next, I'm going to add a new sprite, and the new sprite I'm going to add is a whole orange. So to add a sprite, I click on the kitty cat at the bottom that says choose sprite, and then I look through the list to find the orange, or I can use the search feature and type the word orange, and you can see I have a whole orange there. I'm going to select that, and I'm going to pick it up, drag, and drop it onto my table. Now, I feel like my orange is a little bit small, so the first thing that I want to do is I want to change the size, so I want to make it bigger. So in order to change the size, I use this button at the bottom that says size. So right now it's set to 100 or 100%. So I actually want to increase that. So I might make that 200 and press enter and see what happens. It's a lot bigger, but probably not big enough. So I'm going to increase it by another 100 to make it 300. And I think that's a good size there. Once I have changed the size of my block, I want to give it a couple of instructions. First, I want to give it the instruction to show when the green flag is clicked, because for the rest of the animation, it's going to be hiding or it's going to disappear. But for the beginning, I want to see it. So we're going to use the show. So in order to set it to do that, I click on events and I use the when the green flag is clicked. And then I go into looks and I select the show. So I'm going to have to scroll down and you can see I've got show and hide. So I'm going to use the show block and I'm going to pick that up, drag and drop it onto the pasteboard. So now when my game starts or when I press the green flag, my orange will always appear in this spot. The next thing I want to do is give it some code or some instructions to do things when it's clicked. So I'm going to use the event blocks here, which are the yellow ones on the side. So in the event blocks, I have a block called when this sprite is clicked. And I'm going to pick that one up, drag and drop that onto the pasteboard. So that instruction tells my orange to do something when it's clicked on. And the thing that I want it to do is a few things. First, I want it to make a sound called pop. So I drag and drop that underneath there. Then I want to use that same block again, but this time I'm going to use the record button and I'm going to record an instruction about starting off the orange juice making process by clicking on this orange. So I click on record, click on the orange to start making orange juice. I click save. And again, I name this to, I play
click
to make
on
sure
the orange to start making orange juice.
And then back into code and I change pop to number 2. The next thing I want it to do is hide so that when it's clicked on, it makes these two sounds and then it's going to hide. And then the last thing that I want it to do is this really cool broadcast message. So think of this like a Chinese whisper. So it's going to send like a secret message to the next sprite to tell it, I've disappeared, now it's your turn to show yourself or to come onto the screen. So to get this block, I click on the events block and you'll see I have a whole heap here when I receive, broadcast and broadcast. So I'm going to choose this second one, broadcast message one and wait. So now if I test it out, I press the green flag.
This is my animation on how to make orange juice.
I click on the orange to start the animation.
Click on the orange to start making orange juice.
There you go. In the next video, we'll add the next sprite to appear after it receives message 1.